Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at something new. Yeah, it's not old. This actually just came out earlier tonight, August 2nd. I guess it's just after midnight here, but yeah, this just happened a few hours ago. I know a lot of people always ask for modern malware, and now here's something that's right up my alley. So I actually got a DM about this on Twitter about 5 hours ago, telling me that Classic Shell official download has been infected. It does this to any PC you run it on. Warn your viewers. By the time I got around to actually downloading it and checking it out, everything seemed to be normal. I certainly didn't see this incredibly intriguing screen pop up on my virtual machine, however, I was definitely interested. So I ended up contacting the Twitter handle that's listed in that image, and to my surprise, they got back to me very quickly and hooked me up with a sample to test. So here we have the clean copy of Classic Shell, the setup program. And in here we have the infected copy. Notice how it's named exactly the same, same icon. And if we take a look, the size is just very slightly different. 6.81 megabytes versus 6.88. So unless you were really paying attention looking at the hash, you might overlook this and end up running this if you had downloaded it expecting Classic Shell. When we run the official installer, we go through everything quite normally. Everything installs very easily, quickly. And once it's installed, we now have our classic start menu on Windows 8. So that all works perfectly fine. Now, if you had visited this site during the time that it was infected, you would have received this file. And when we run this, we will say yes, go ahead and allow it to make changes. And window pops up and nothing appears to happen. And some people I know like to look on VirusTotal to see if whatever they downloaded is, you know, malicious or anything like that, but take a look at some of these results. This is virtually undetected. Only a few detections, and all of these are just generic "you don't want this on your computer" detections, nothing specific. So this is definitely brand new. Apparently, along with the infected copy of Classic Shell, they also uploaded an infected copy of Audacity to FossHub, which apparently they gained access to replace these files and serve up these malware downloads. So now, we're going to go ahead and reboot, because I know we all want to see that message. And once we boot up here, instead of Windows, we get the message, as you reboot, you find that something has overwritten your MBR. It is a sad thing your adventures have ended here. Direct all hate to Peggle Crew on Twitter. And then a bunch of greets. So this is very, very nostalgic here. If you've watched my channel for any length of time, you've seen many, many pieces of malware do stuff very similar to this. And this is pretty unheard of in this day and age, especially for something that's out in the wild and has actually infected people who are talking about this on the internet, on forums, trying to get it off their machines, what have you. Now, fixing this is not too difficult. This does not intentionally damage data that I've seen or that they've actually said. As far as I've seen, this just overwrites your MBR, which is a pretty simple fix. We're going to go ahead and try to do that. So now we're actually booting into the Windows 8.1 recovery CD, just the installation media. And I was able to repair this pretty simply before. If we go to repair your computer, we can troubleshoot. Advanced, use the command prompt to do fix. What is it? Fix boot rack. Yeah, there we go. And then if we exit out of this, run the startup repair. That worked just fine for me. We'll see if it works this time. And hey, here we go. It appears to have worked. We are actually booting into Windows instead of our message on the master boot record. So all my files are still here. That desktop is exactly as I left it. Everything seems to be in order, so some people have said they've had to wipe their drives. With stuff like this, anything really goes. Sometimes you run into unintentional side effects when your malware infects things in the wild, and stuff that's supposed to not damage anything can end up doing lots of damage. But in this case, for me personally, I haven't seen anything that indicates a vast amount of damage. Now, there could be any number of password stealing or credential stealing or any other things bundled with this, as with any undetected malware. But from what I've seen, from what they've said on Twitter, it's not the end of the world. However, it's definitely a warning that sites can easily become compromised and things you download could easily end up doing scary stuff like this to your computer. So definitely an interesting case, definitely something I was interested in taking a look at. Hopefully you are not hit by this, hopefully a future site intrusion does not occur and you have to deal with something like this, but that is about it. There are some extra removal instructions in case my tips didn't work for you in the description. They were sent to me by Break the Limit on Twitter, so if you're affected by this, check them out, maybe they can help you. So thank you for watching, that's about it, take care. And once we finish booting into Windows here, I hate VirtualBox so much.